Peer review is often portrayed as an infallible mechanism for ensuring scientific integrity, but this notion is problematic for several reasons. Quote, the primary function of peer review is gatekeeping, close quote, Britannica.com. Firstly, the senior academics and scientists who review scientific papers are typically well-established figures in prevailing paradigms. While their expertise in the field is essential for evaluation, this can also lead to accusations of bias. If scientists have spent their careers invested in a particular paradigm, considering alternative views may be uncomfortable or even threatening. The term cognitive dissonance comes to mind. Quote, the peer review system often creates near insurmountable hurdles against the publication of data that seems contrary to long-held beliefs. Close quote, Dr. Friedman T. Freund. Underlining this, when the philosopher Thomas Kuhn set out to write a book about the history of science, he was surprised to discover that almost every scientific breakthrough initially met with hostility. In his famous book, The Structure of Scientific Revolutions, he coined the term paradigm shift, noting that science rarely proceeds smoothly, but rather by revolutions that eventually overcome entrenched thinking. Quote, in science, as in the playing card experiment, novelty emerges only with difficulty, manifested by resistance against a background provided by expectation. Close quote, Thomas Kuhn. This famous quote by Max Planck is more blunt. It is generally summarized as, science proceeds funeral by funeral. Close quote. Secondly, another concern is that peer reviewers enjoy anonymity, which, while potentially protecting them from external influence, raises questions about accountability. Anonymity allows reviewers to promote favored theories and stifle dissent without consequence. There is some evidence for this, which we will come to. Quote, science today is locked into paradigms. Every avenue is blocked by beliefs that are wrong. And if you try to get anything published by a journal today, you will run against a paradigm and the editors will turn it down. Close quote. Fred Hoyle. Thirdly, it's important to remember that peer review is not the final word, despite what many seem to think. A peer-reviewed paper merely signifies that it has been scrutinized and has passed muster as good science. But conflicting conclusions may arise from other peer-reviewed work. For example, Wolf Thornhill's paper, The Z-Pinch Morphology of Supernova 1987A and Electric Stars, published by the prestigious IEEE, Institute of Electrical and Electronics Engineers, examines supernovas from the perspective of plasma and electromagnetism, factors often ignored in mainstream astrophysics, which focuses on nuclear reactions in a gravity-dominated universe. Another paper from 2017 claims, quote, the external energy supply to the sun is overwhelmingly obvious and has recently been detected by space probes. Close quote. At the top of page 5, it reminds us that, quote, under the standard solar model, the origin and mechanism of the sun's magnetic field are still mysterious. Close quote. Thornhill also critiques the conventional dirty snowball model of comets from an electric universe perspective in his paper, The Electrical Nature of Comets. A list of the peer-reviewed papers Thornhill has written or contributed to can be viewed here. Scientific consensus. In scientific debates, it's common for opposing parties to cite peer-reviewed studies that support their respective viewpoints. However, these studies can sometimes present conflicting conclusions. So, who decides which research holds more weight? The answer isn't always straightforward, and it's easy to cherry-pick findings that favour a particular argument. At this stage, one side might invoke the concept of scientific consensus, groupthink, some might say, claiming that the sheer volume of studies supporting their position makes their view more credible. While this may seem reasonable on the face of it, science is not governed by consensus in the same way politics is. In science, evidence should always outweigh the number of hands raised in agreement. Moreover, emerging fields of research, by their very nature, may have less peer-reviewed literature yet still hold significant scientific promise. Quote, the burden of proof has been inverted. Unpopular claims require extraordinary evidence. Popular claims only seem to require a show of hands. Close quote. Stuart Talbot, Thunderbolts Project. So, where does this leave us? Given Thomas Kuhn's insight that new ideas generally meet resistance, who's to say the emerging plasma universe paradigm isn't a viable alternative? While it does not claim to have all the answers, and probably never will, it offers an approach that avoids over-reliance on mathmagics and exotic hypotheticals, something the standard gravity-only model seems increasingly dependent on. Hence all the talk of cosmology in crisis. Quote, science is the belief in the ignorance of the experts, close quote, Richard Feynman. The electric universe model, contrary to what some might think, is neither without scientific pedigree nor peer-reviewed validation. Hannes Alfvén, the Swedish physicist regarded as the father of plasma physics and plasma cosmology, eventually won a long-overdue Nobel Prize for his pioneering work. His fellow Scandinavian, Christian Björkland, was likely headed for similar recognition before his untimely death shortly after being nominated. Today, electric currents in space are named in his honour, Björkland currents. This excellent web resource lists some more recent peer-reviewed EU material. Plasmas and politics. In addition to material directly supporting the electric universe EU model, Dr. Garda Shahad, a critical discourse analysis, uses the term EU-adjacent language to describe the growing body of scientific papers that subtly endorse the plasma or electric universe model. These papers often temper their language, possibly mindful of the lingering taboo surrounding discussions of electricity in space. This paper, for example, is headed Coulomb Universe in a Jellium Droplet. The first word could just as easily read electric. Another example comes from Earth and Space Science in a paper titled Simulations of Io Plasma Taurus Around Jupiter. The paper emphasizes that, quote, characterizing the temporal evolution of the three-dimensional structure of the Io Plasma Taurus is essential to understanding the dynamics of the Jovian magnetosphere, close quote. An electric current between Jupiter and Io, estimated to be in the region of 2 million amperes, is thought to power the glowing Taurus. Although papers that support the EU model, either directly or indirectly, are now sneaking through with increasing regularity, this is not to say that academic peer review is not a problem. We are witnessing the beginning of a paradigm shift, but it is meeting with resistance. Quote, peer review doesn't work. It only works to protect the status quo, the settled science, close quote, Wallace Thornhill. An open letter to closed minds. As previously mentioned, accusations of bias have long been levelled at the peer review system. In May 2004, several prominent scientists, plasma physicists, and independent researchers signed a petition titled An Open Letter to the Scientific Community. It was published in The New Scientist and dubbed An Open Letter to Closed Minds in some quarters. The letter highlighted several key issues, including the Big Bang Theory's increasing dependence on hypothetical entities, the reluctance within the scientific community to explore alternative models, and the inherent bias of peer review, which remains dominated by Big Bangers. Quote, of course, if one ignores contradictory observations, one can claim to have an elegant or robust theory, but it isn't science. Close quote. Holton Arp. Regrettably, little progress has been made in the last 20 years. In 2022, another controversy erupted involving the censorship of papers that challenged the prevailing Big Bang model. Wikipedia. We've all heard it. After mentioning Wikipedia, many would qualify their utterance with a sarcastic, "Yes, I know." While Wikipedia might be useful for simple factoids, such as the population of Plymouth in the UK, or the location of the Liberty Bell in the US, to give two random examples, it is no revelation to suggest that Wikipedia may not be an entirely reliable or unbiased source, contrary to the noble ideals it may have started out with. One area where Wikipedia falls short is its treatment of peer-reviewed research, particularly when it challenges orthodoxy. For example, a few years ago, I added a section titled Predictions Prior to the Big Bang to the Wikipedia page on the Cosmic Microwave Background, CMB. The content, which remained unmolested for about 6 months, was simply a factual summary and supported by a peer-reviewed paper, Despite its lack of controversy, it was removed by a senior editor. As it stands, anyone reading the Wikipedia page on the CMB right now might come away believing that it provides irrefutable evidence for the Big Bang. However, the reality is that several scientists predicted the background temperature of space before Big Bang proponents claimed it as confirmation of their theory. From the paper, quote, "In this paper we show that other models of a universe in dynamical equilibrium without expansion have predicted this temperature prior to Gamow. Moreover, we show that Gamow's own predictions were worse than these previous ones." Close quote. To ensure balance and accuracy, it would seem only fair to include the full history of CMB predictions prior to its discovery. Wikipedia, however, disagreed, citing weak excuses for the removal and even dismissing the work of leading plasma scientists like Eric Lerner and Anthony Perrett as fringe science, despite their impressive credentials. Both men were mentored by Nobel Prize-winning physicist Hannes Alfvén, and Perrett spent much of his career at Los Alamos National Laboratories. This dismissal of alternative views, especially those challenging the Big Bang, reflects a broader pattern. One Wikipedia editor implied that such challenges are conspiratorial, yeah, that old chestnut, and confessed that peer review is insufficient for inclusion. Instead, they prioritise secondary sources, often mainstream media. You have to laugh. In my humble opinion, the actions of Wikipedia represent bad faith and historical revisionism. I could use stronger language, but I'll do the British thing and bite my lip. Quote, "The CMB is a radio fog of dense plasma filaments," close quote, Eric Lerner, LPP Fusion. If Lerner is right, the CMB tells us nothing about the age of the universe. Peer review in crisis. While we often hear of cosmology in crisis, the truth is that the two are inextricably entwined. This excellent piece from Dr. Richard Smith, a former editor of the estimable BMJ, British Medical Journal, is titled, quote, "Peer Review, a Flawed Process at the Heart of Science and Journals," close quote. Although cosmology and astrophysics may seem a little intangible to many, concerns relating to medicine bite much closer to home. Here is a short extract from the first paragraph, quote, "Its defects are easier to identify than its attributes, yet it shows no signs of going away," close quote. The last century reveals the failure of many involved in the scientific process to uphold its ideals. This is particularly troubling given that science is supposed to be a self-correcting mechanism. In this hard-hitting video from YouTube channel Theories of Everything, maverick mathematician Gregory Chaitin argues that there has been no scientific innovation since the 1920s because science has become a big business that suppresses true innovation. Interestingly, at 3 minutes and 33 seconds, he mentions ball lightning as something widely accepted yet little understood. A nod in the direction of the plasma universe, perhaps? Talking of dogma and suppression, in his now infamous blog post, "Doubt and Dissent Are Not Tolerated," Sean Carroll of Johns Hopkins University went so far as to label anyone who questions the Big Bang as a crackpot, asserting that any research challenging the theory is, quote, "just not worth the bother," close quote. If that doesn't sound like ideology, I don't know what does, and again, I'm being polite. Imagine if Carroll has refereed papers that dare to challenge the Big Bang. How would we know? Plasma physicist Eric Lerner first published his bestseller, The Big Bang Never Happened, in 1991. Nearly 30 years later, in 2020, data from the James Webb Space Telescope confirmed many of his predictions. One astronomer even reacted to the JWST findings with the exclamation, panic. Quote, "The glowing list of failed predictions of the inflationary lambda CDM theory is a widely recognized crisis in cosmology. It is therefore timely to re-examine if the Big Bang hypothesis, BBH, which underlies the dominant cosmological model, is valid." Close quote. Eric Lerner. Insider trading. In the last episode of the Misconception series, Where is the Math?, two comments beneath the video jokingly likened scientific bias to insider trading. It's an intriguing metaphor, particularly when considering the peer review process. Quote, the public has a distorted view of science because children are taught in school that science is a collection of firmly established truths. In fact, science is not a collection of truths. It is a continuing exploration of mysteries. Close quote, Freeman Dyson. Political shenanigans are nothing new, of course. For some reason, however, big science generally escapes scrutiny. Perhaps this is because many have an idealized view of scientists as quiet people who spend their lives looking into a microscope, shunning the limelight and following the evidence wherever it may lead. In recent years, however, that perception has started to shift. I frequently hear variations of the question, how can we trust the science if the science follows the money? It certainly seems that challenging scientific scripture remains heretical in some circles. Hannes Alfvén probably put it best, quote, the peer review system is satisfactory during quiescent times, but not during a revolution in a discipline such as astrophysics, when the establishment seeks to preserve the status quo. Close quote. The term high priests of science is much reviled by the scientific community. All the same, I can't help thinking it might be about time to kick the tables in their temple over. In the next episode of our Misconception series, Part 5, we will take a look at another common question. What about gravity?